not much of the show left. But we couldn't not have a cake and flowers. Oh. Come on in, Dad. Safely, for God's sake.
Craigie,
Oh,
it's even got the... It's even got the ring pull on top.
It does. Give it a pull, Sarah. Oh, you're good at that.
Amazing. The other one.
I love this. Now, we've seen lots of lovely surprises and look-backs, but we do have a way of kind of summing up your 9 years here on Studio 10. Here's a little look back on your time as our wonderful bus driver on Studio 10.
It's time to smarten up your morning with Ita, Joe, Jess and Sarah.
We've come a long, long way together through the hard times and the good.
Hello and welcome to Studio 10. It is great to have you with us for our very first show.
I have to praise you like I should.
Yes, Sarah?
Do you pee in the shower?
No, Sarah.
I'm sorry.
That's great, isn't it?
Wow.
Remember
I said to you that spinach cough was going to go right through me?
There we go. Look at this. Here we go.
Oh, no.
Is that making more of a mess,
oh,
do you
my gosh.
Okay, I'll
very
just keep beavering away here. Don't you worry about that.
My mic's falling down my face.
That's all right.
Hello, it's Sarah. I am shocking. My voicemail.
You know that moment where you think, should I? Hi, Jono. What year were you famous?
I was famous.
Speaking of mofos, hi, Jono.
Hello.
I've just sampled all the food for Sarah's upcoming nuptials, and I've also sampled the sheets and the bed linen for the honeymoon.
What a horrible Jess. I've seen your nipples.
Yeah, you have. They're not too bad, are
You've got good little nipples. Red card.
Watch out, Blondie.
You're like a deranged poodle this morning.
You're going to fire that into the palm of my hand.
Nah!
Stop. You're just going...
Remember which way!
Rebecca's again.
What has two thumbs and wasn't at the Logies?
This guy!
Around once I leave work, I take off my pretty frocks, the heavy makeup and the hair. I take off my Spanx, which I'm still wearing. You know, that's what I look like, and that's okay.
Right on.
And I hope those photos of me make other pregnant women feel better about their bodies, because I'm kind of fed up with the body shaming that happens when you're pregnant, and then the pressure that comes afterwards to lose the baby weight. And on behalf of all of the pregnant women out there who might be feeling a little bit chubby and a little bit flabby, on behalf of all of them, I want to say to the haters, get stuffed. Yeah. Yay! Did you ever let yourself go down that dark path? You've got two beautiful kids, Oscar and Emily, who are young adults. Did you let your mind go to the fact that, you know, maybe I won't see...
Absolutely.
..Emily have a family, or I won't be there for Oscar?
You know, I want them to experience all the things that I've experienced, and I want to be there for that. And those are the things, the dark times that get in your mind.
Some breaking news now. Let's take you to Queensland now, where the Premier is speaking.
I'd have to interrupt you. We need to take people now out live to the US. Donald J. Trump has just been impeached.
We are coming to you live from inside the RFS headquarters here in Sydney.
Guys, we have genuinely to cut you off just one moment. We've got some breaking news just coming through. Nelson Mandela has just passed away.
Mentioned when I was a little nappy head boy, and I never put down my alto saxophone. Buck tripping down on a boulevard. I couldn't wait to blow my own horn. It ain't wrong for you to play alone.
What am I doing?
Okay, good. Come in a bit closer, guys. Come on, let's all squeeze in. This is the part where I'm going to cry. Now, can I just say that I am immensely, immensely proud and so very grateful to have spent almost a decade hosting Studio 10. It's like a century in TV years. And seriously, it has been the best job I have ever had, and I've worked in a lot of newsrooms over the years. This is the nicest place to work. I've made such good friends, lifelong friends, that I'm going to cherish forever. But I'm just one small part in what is a very big and wild and wonderful show that simply would not get to air if it wasn't for the team of people, talented people, working their bums off behind the scenes. So after spending better part of 3.5 hours saying lots of nice things about me, I'd like to say some nice things about you guys. To our incredible floor and control room crew who lean into the chaos of our crazy little show every single day, thank you. You make everything run, sound and look better, all of you. But much more than that, you just make this job fun. You give great car advice. You change the clocks, Andy, on my car. To our brilliant floor managers, Loza and Erin, who do the impossible job of herding us cats every single day. Love your guts. Honourable mention must go to the man, the myth, the legend, Herman. Woo! The cameraman. I loved him from the first day that I spent here at Channel 10. And Steph, so can I get this guy his own show? Can we at least get him an Instagram page or something?
Yes.
To the girls in hair and makeup, especially Annalise, Mon and Renee, thank you for all the laughs and for talking me out of cutting a full fringe on more than one occasion. To Rach and Amanda and the styling team at 10 who put me together every day and they dressed me through two pregnancies on television. Frankly, I'd be hosting the show in my activewear if it wasn't for you, so thank you so much. You were just the best. To our wonderful production team led by Raj, Kim and Matt, I love you guys. I love you guys so much. Enough to cop a pie in the face or maybe a slip on a sumo suit or even ride a mechanical bull on my last day. I used to be a journalist. You know, it is a bloody long, hard slog to get so many hours of television to air every single day, especially during a global pandemic and especially when our little show went through these seismic shifts. You're all superstars. Thank you so much for everything. Thanks for making us look good. A special shout out has to go to Vicky. She's the mother hen of our office. I did steal this line from Ben Fordham's radio show, but it's bloody true. Vicky, you're just like chicken salt. You make everything better. To Tamara, who I know is watching at home sobbing because she is the chief crier. But she is also everyone's biggest cheerleader. You have the world's biggest heart, and I hope this teenage punk can do you proud. My castmates, my TV family, it's been such an honour to share this couch with all of you, with hosts present and past, and I can't wait to see what the new era of Studio 10 looks like. You've changed your time slot, so surely now that you've saved some money with me, get a new couch. T-Mac, my young Padawan, I know you're watching from home and I know you're devo not to be here today. I'm so sorry. You were thrown into this seat next to me. I'm getting wound. And straight away, you shone. My aunts came all the way from Penrith. Yay! 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 You've carried me through some really dark days, mate, and you taught me to waltz. Love your partner. Feel better soon. Love to that beautiful family of yours. And finally, to our viewers who've embraced me so warmly on Studio 10, thank you so much. I will never forget how kind you've been to me. Make sure you watch the project, all right? I mean it. I'm going to miss you all. It's been an incredible ride. Love you so much.
Bye. We love you, Jenny.